Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Study with Soumya. Make sure to subscribe this channel if you haven't subscribed till now. This channel is definitely going to be very helpful for you, so make sure to subscribe. Also turn on the bell icon so that you don't miss any opportunity from the channel. And do join us at our Telegram channel. The link for the Telegram channel is given in the description itself. Well, in this video is with the reference of continuation of the TCS May and QT aptitude preparation. So we'll be discussing further questions on percentage concept, right? So we'll be discussing some more questions on the percentage concepts, and then we'll start the profit and loss. Also, I've already made few videos regarding TCS May and QT aptitude. If you haven't watched them, I would recommend to watch them so that you can get a proper understanding of all the topics. So let's start with the first question now. Here's the first question. That if the length of the rectangle is increased by 37 into 1/2% and its breadth is decreased by 16 into 2/3%, find the approximate percent change in its area. First of all, what is 37 1/2%? It is nothing but 37 to 2, 74 plus 75 by 2. And to convert this in fraction, we have to basically divide by 100, 25 to 75, 25 4 to 100, and here we are having 3/8, and 16 2/3 can be written as 50/3, and just you have to multiply by 100, and this is going to give us 1/6. Okay, so they are saying in the question, it is mentioned that the length of rectangle is increased by 37 into 1/2%, that is this one, right? So initially the length was 8. You must be knowing the formula for the area of rectangle, that is L into B, right? So initially in the starting, the length was 8. Now it has increased. So 8 plus 3, that is going to give us 11. For the breadth case, they have 7. They have given that it has been decreased by 16 into 2/3%. That is nothing but this particular fraction. So it means initially it was 6. And now it has reduced by one unit, by one factor, that is 6 minus 1. So we have to write 5 here. So initially the area was 48, and afterwards the area became 55. So what is the change? What is the difference? It is 7. So basically you have to tell the approximate percent change in its area. So you can see the difference is of 7 unit, and we have to calculate the percentage on the actual area, that is 48. To convert this to percentage, simply multiply by 100. And if you will be solving this, so first of all we will be cancelling that, so we are going to get something like this is going to give us 175/12. And if you will further solve it out, so we are going to get 40 into 7/12%. So this is going to be the correct answer for this particular question. Let's discuss the next question now. So in this question, we are basically discussing that what is the investment of Soumya, that is me itself. So basically we are having in the question that Soumya spends 40% of her salary on house rent. So let's suppose my salary is 100, and 40% of it, that is 40% of 100 is going to be 40 itself. So 40 I am investing in house rent. Okay, now the remaining is 60. Okay, and on the remaining 10% spends on travel. 60 is remaining to me, right? And even on this particular remaining part, I am spending 10% on travels. So 10% of 60 is going to be 6 itself, right? It is going to be 6. So 6 I have spent on the travel. Now how much money is remaining? 54. You can see 54 is remaining. Now what given? That on remaining 16 into 2/2% is spent on food. So now the remaining is 54, and out of which 16 into 2/3% is spent on the food. 16 2/3%, I have just told you it is nothing but 1/6. Okay, it is 1/6. So 1/6 of 54 is going to give us 9. So 9 part of this 54 is spent on food, and remaining it's saved. So what is remaining? What is remaining here? 54 minus 9 is going to give us 45. Okay, so 45 part is remaining part, and they are saying that if she saved rupees 6750, it means you can see here we are getting that 45 money is saved, and the question they are giving that 6750 rupees are saved. So 45 equal to 6750, that is what we can do. And if you will further solve this, then what we are going to get, if you will solve it, so we are going to get 1 equal to 150, right? So now they are asking what amount she spent on. So you can see this 9 unit was spent on food, right? So what amount is spent? 1 into 9, and that is 150 into 9. So 9 equal to, that is going to give us 1350. Okay, so 1350 rupees are invested or like spent on the food itself. I hope the question is clear. Let's move to the next question now. In this question, they are saying that price of a sugar is increased by 16 into 2 by 3%. That is nothing but 1 by 6, right? And the consumption of a family is decreased. So you must be knowing that price is inversely proportional to that of consumption. If price is increasing, it means consumption will be reducing, right? So what they are saying that if price increased by 16 into 2 by 3% and consumption of a family decreased by 20%, you have to determine the percentage change in expenditure. So you can see this is the relation that I just told you. So the price is increasing by 1 unit. You can see this, we can write it like as it is. So initially price was P1 and now it is P2. So initially price was 6 and now it is 7. Also, it is given that due to which the consumption of family decreased by 20%, 20% is nothing but 1 by 5. So we can say consumption initially was 5 and now it has become 4, right? So this is what given. Now expenditure equal to, we know that it is price into consumption, right? So here you can see for this one we are getting 6 into 5, that is 30, and for this one, that is new price and new consumption, we are getting 7 into 4, that is 28. So what is the difference between the expenditure? Basically 2 units, that is the difference. So we have to determine the percentage basically on the original expenditure. So initially it was 30, so 2 upon 30 into 100, that is what we have to do. And if you will solve it, so 215, 100 divided by 15, so that is going to, let's divide it further. So 5, 3 is 50 and 20, so it is going to give us 6 into 2 by 3%, right? I hope the question is clear. Let's move to the next question now. In the next question, we are having that a reduction of 25% in the price of sugar enables a person to purchase 4 kg more of rupees 800. Find the original and current price per kg. Well, there are two methods by using which we can solve this question. Let's discuss the first approach first, right? So what we can do, you can see here they have given that reduction is of 25%, and 25% is nothing but 1 by 4. Okay, if you haven't watched my previous video regarding percentages, then I would recommend to watch that one. Only then you will be able to understand that how I'm writing this 1 by 4 and all sort of thing, right? So 25% is what? 1 by 4. So reduction of 25% in the price of sugar. So initially price was 4 and now it has reduced by 1 unit, that is now price is 3. So it enables a person to purchase 4 kg more of rupees 800. So you must be knowing that price is inversely proportional to quantity. So if price is decreasing, it means quantity will increase. So from this relation, what we can say that initially quantity was 3 and now it has become 4. Right? This is what we can conclude. So they are saying, in the question they are saying, reduction of price enables a person to purchase 4 kg more. But here you can see the quantity has increased by 1. So we can directly say that 1 is equal to 4. 1 is equal to 4. It means this 3 we can write it as 12. So 3 is going to be 12. Here also we have to multiply this with 4. So 4 into 4, that is going to give us 16. Right? So this is what? Quantity. This is initial quantity and this is after the reduction. So they are asking the initial one, that is original one, and current price also. The initial one is going to be nothing but 800 divided by 12. So original price is going to be, initial price is going to be 800 divided by 12, so that is nothing but, if you will solve, so 66.66. And here if you are trying to determine the price, so that is going to be 800 divided by 16. 16 is what? Quantity, right? So that is going to give us 50. So you can see here the price of this one was greater than that of this one, right? So this was the first approach that we can use to solve this question. Let's see the another approach as well. So the next approach to solve this particular question is that what we can do, just take the amount given and the reduction mentioned also. So 25 by 100 it is, and equate it to the amount, equate it to the how much you can purchase more. So 4 kg they have given, and if you will solve it, 25 400 4 200 and 4 50, right? So what we are going to get, that 1 kg, from here you can conclude that 1 kg is equal to 50 rupees, right? 1 kg is equal to 50 rupees. So that is what, due to the reduction, this is what our current price. Okay, this is what current price. Now if you want to determine the original price or initial price, so for this what we have to do, so for initial one or original one, we have to take this, simply take this 50 divided by 100 minus the reduction is of 25. Also, if there is, instead of reduction, if there is some sort of increment, so here you have to use the addition symbol instead of using this subtraction one. And 50, and to convert this in percentage, we have to use 100 and into 100. So if we solve it, we are going to get 50, 75 into 100, 25, 4, 3, and that is going to give us 66.66. Okay, so we are getting the same answer by using both the approaches. Now let's see the next question. So here also you can use the two approaches that we just discussed. So let's use the second approach as of now. So what is the increment? You can see 30% is the increment and price is 520. So simply do 520 into 30 by 100, and we can purchase 6 apples less, right? So equal to 6 we have to do, and if you will solve it, so we are going to have this has been cut, so 3 into 2 and this is 26. So we are going to have that this one unit is equal to 26 rupees. Now what we have to do, so this is what, this is our new price that we got, right? So this is our new price that we got after the increment in the price. Now we have to determine old price as well. So for old price, I just told you the simple formula we have to use, is that use this 26, and as if there is increment, so we have to do the addition. I just told you, so 100 plus 30, so by 30% there is increment, so you have to do 100 plus 30 into 100. And if you will solve this further, let's solve this 26, 130 into 100, and 32 jar 26. So we are going to get 20 as the answer. So 20 rupees was the old price or initial price, and after doing the 30% increment in the price, new price is going to be 26 rupees. Right, so I hope you understood the question. Let's see the next question now. Next question says that in an examination, Ram got 30% of the max marks and failed by 80 marks. Whereas Shyam got 200 marks and failed by 15 marks. Find the passing percentage marks in the sem. Well, here let's consider a case that if Ram got these 80 marks also, then he must have passed, right? So what we can do, that 30% plus 80. So if he got that 80 marks as well, so he must have passed. Similarly, the same case apply here as well, that Shyam got 200 marks and failed by 50%. So if he got that 50% extra, so he must have passed, right? So we can write 200 plus 15%, right? And what we can do, just take this percentage aside. So that is going to be 15% equal to 120 and 1% equal to, right, and if we are checking 100%, so that is going to give us 800. So like total exam, like the marks of the total exam is that of 100. Okay, so 100, 800 marks is, so the marks of the exam is 800. So this is the total marks, 800 is the total marks. Now they are asking the passing percentage marks in the exam. So simply either you can use this equation or this equation, we are going to get same answer from both of them. So 15 by 100 into 800, so that is going to give us 120 plus 200, so that is going to give us 320. Also if we are using this one also, so 30 by 100 into 80 plus 80, we are going to get, so 8 3 24, okay, one extra zero should be here, so 240 plus 80, again this is going to give us 320. So 320 is the passing marks. Now they are asking the passing percentage, so we have to convert this into percentage. So we can do just simply 320 divided by total marks, that is 800 into 100, and that is going to give us 40%, right? So 40% is going to be the percentage marks. I hope the question is clear. Now let's move to the next question. Now the next question says that the sum of AB and C, A plus B plus C, the sum of salary of A plus B plus C is 72,000, right? And also if they spend 80%, 85% and 75% of their salary, right? So if A is spending 80%, so how much is remaining? 20%. Similarly, if B is spending 85%, so how much is remaining? 15%. And in the case of C as well, 25% is remaining. So this is what the ratio we are getting for the savings. But here in the question, they have already given that this is what the ratio is. So what we can do, 20% we are getting, 15% and 25%. Also, this is the ratio that given in the question, that 8, 9, 20. Just simply equate these, like is 20% equal to 8. So 100% means just multiply 5 both the sides. So 5 into 20, that is 100%, that is going to give us 40. Similarly here, 15% is equal to 9. So what we can do, just okay, so 15% is equal to 9, that is what given. So we have to convert this to 100%. So just multiply 100 both the side and 9 into 100, right? So this 15 we will take here, and 100%, that is going to give us 900 by 15, and that is nothing but 60, right? So for B it is 60, and for C we have to calculate. So for in the case of C, we are having 25% equal to 20. It means 100% equal to 80. So this is what we are getting, the salary of A, B and C. A salary is what? 40. B salary is 60 and C salary is 80. And they have given that it is equal to 72,000. If you will solve it, so we are going to get 180 equal to 72,000. That is what we will get. So 1 equal to, we will get 400, right? So this is what we will get. Now we have to determine the salary of A. So salary of A is going to be nothing but 40 into 400, that is 16,000. So salary of A is 16,000, right? Let's see the next question now. That is 8% of the voters in an election did not cast their votes. So let's suppose there was 100% voter, out of them 8% did not cast their votes. So how many are remaining? 92%. In this election there was only two candidates. Fine, the winner by obtaining 48% of the total votes defeated his contestant by 1100 votes. So see, these many didn't even participate, so we have to consider this 92% only. So out like from this 92%, 48% of the total votes defeated the winner, obtained 48% of the total votes and defeated his contestant. So for the defeated one, what is the number of votes? Right, what is the number of vote? That is going to be 44%. What is the difference here between the votes? That is 4%. But here in the question they have given that total votes defeated his contestant by 1100 votes. It means this 4 equal to 1100. It means 1 equal to 4 2 j 8 7 275, right? So they are asking that total number of voters in the election was, so it was 100%, right? So we can just simply multiply 100 both the side and 275. Okay, so this is going to be our correct answer. That is 27,500 voters were there, and out of, you can see 8% didn't participate, like they did not cast their vote in the election. Okay, so let's see the next question now. Next question says that fresh fruit contains 68% water. Right, so this is the fresh fruit contains 68% water and dry fruit contains 20% water. So you have to determine that how many kg of dry fruits can be made from 75 kg of fresh fruits. Fine, so what we have to do, so fruit contains of water and pulp, right? Fruit contains of water and pulp. So here you can see for fresh fruit they have given pulp and water. So water is 68%, right? Water is 68%. So the remaining 68%. So the remaining, that is 100 minus 68, so the remaining is what? Pulp, right? So this is what the ratio of pulp and water. Even you can simplify it further. So that is going to give us 870. So that is the ratio for fresh food. And in the case of dry food, they have given that dry food contains 20% water. It means 1 by 5 fraction we are getting. That is, this 1 unit is water. So 5 minus 1 is going to be, that is 4 is going to be pulp. So that is what we are getting from the dry food. Now just understand one thing, that in the case of dry and in the case of fresh food also, pulp is going to be same, right? The water is going to change. The water amount of water is going to change, although pulp is going to be same, right? So here you can see pulp is different, so you have to make it same for both the cases, fresh and dry food. So what we can do, just multiply this whole by 2. So that is going to give us 8 and 2 here. So what we can see, that this 25 fresh food is able to give us 10 dry food. So 25 fresh food is able to give us 10 dry food. It means one fresh food can give us 10 by 25 dry foods, and they're asking 75 kg of fresh food. So just multiply by 75, 10 into 75, 25. Okay. So you can see 30 kg of dry foods we are getting in the answer. 30 kg of dry foods can be made from 75 kg of fresh foods, right? So this was the last question of this video. I hope you understood all the questions that we discussed in the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you like the video. And if possible, then make sure to share this video with your friends as well, so that even they can revise the concept of percentage. Thank you so much. Keep watching, keep learning.